Hello guys, my name is Joey Mande and I will be your teacher for Math 3. So on today's lesson, we gonna be focused only on arc length, and then that's basically what's gonna happen. So we'll try to make sure that we understand this part today, so that tomorrow we're gonna start already with the calculation of volume. Okay, so as I said, on today's lesson it's gonna be all about arc length. Okay, so we have two formulas that we have to keep in mind. The first one is when it's given as a rectangular coordinate. So when it's given as a rectangular coordinate, we're gonna use this formula. What you need is only this formula. And then when it's given as parametric equation, what you need is this formula. Okay, and then as well, I'm gonna make sure that I will give you access to a video about a revision of some derivative property. So I'm gonna give you access to that video if you still have some challenge to do your derivative, because today we don't have really time to go through all derivative. But the most important one that you can keep in mind is that table is our chain rule. Chain rule is, let's say for instance we have a function u, and then you have to derivate it. We know that what's gonna happen, you have to drop the power, then you take u n minus 1, then you derive your function u. Okay, and then you have as well your product rule when you have the two function uv. Okay, and then when you have to derive two functions stick together, what happened? You derive u times v plus u times v. And then you have as well your chain rule. Your chain rule, this will be your formula. And then what's gonna happen is you derive the first function v minus u, v you derive, and then your v become squared. Okay, and then another one to keep in mind is when we have to derive a square root. Okay, this is just a special formula that I'm gonna give you. Just take the function that is inside the square root, then you derive it, you divide by 2 over that square root. So this is just some small revision on derivative, but since I said I'm gonna give you access to those videos, you can go and watch yourself and do some revision on derivative. So we're gonna have a look on under your tutorial question, which I have already uploaded on the website. You can download your learner guide. And as you can see, this is a parametric. Why parametric? Because we are dealing with two functions, x and y. Okay, so what's gonna happen, we need to apply our arc length formula for the parametric function, which is states like this. Okay, sorry for that. Ddx, so you can see it's all about derivative. If you forgot some of your derivative, make sure you watch that video under Math 2. Okay, so that formula we're gonna apply. But what I'm going to suggest to you in order for you to solve this problem very well is that, remember that you need to break it into a problem, because math, it's like a problem. If you solve it everything at once, you're gonna make a small mistake somewhere around. So what we are gonna do, first of all, we are going to look for the derivative. Okay, once we get the derivative, then we look for the square, the power of that derivative. Okay, second step. Okay, and then we do the same here. We look for the derivative for this function. Okay, first step. Second step, the power of that derivative. And then on the third step, what will happen, we take everything now, we add them. Okay, and then after, now we are going to introduce our square root. So I want you to break it into pieces so that you see what you are doing, and once you see what you are doing, you won't make any mistake. Okay, so as I said, we're gonna break it into pieces, and our first step, as we said, we are going to look for the derivative of this first parametric function d dx d d theta. Okay, so you have 5, a constant, cos plus, okay, so we are going to look for the derivative of this function. Okay, and already you can see that you have a 5 is a constant, we keep it aside, we are not gonna care about it. Okay, so now we have a product rule here, we have a sum here. So we are going to take the derivative of cos plus the derivative of theta sine theta. Okay, So if you can notice already, here it's only one function, okay? And then you come down here, you say 5. The derivative, of course, give us what? Minus sine theta. Under your formula sheet, plus. If you look here, what you observe is what? You have a product rule of what? This function and that function. So you apply your product rule formula. Then you derive first the theta sine plus the theta, and then you derive the sine theta. So I'm just going step by step. This, because this is the first video, but once we move forward, we're going to make it a bit quick. And then when you go down, what's happened now? You have 5 minus sine theta. The derivative of theta give us what? 1. Then you have sine theta plus derivative of sine in under your formula should give us what? Cos. Okay? So you can observe, you see that this and that will cancel each other, and therefore you only gonna remain with 5 theta cos theta. Once you find your derivative, the second step is you look for the square of this derivative. So it's gonna be 2 d dx d theta, all of that to the power of 2, and therefore it's gonna be d theta cos theta, and then you put your power to it. And then 4, when you go forward with it, what you're gonna see is that you're gonna have 25, because 5 to the power of 2 is 25. And then you have theta squared, then you have your cos squared theta. This cos squared is the same as when you write cos theta to the power of 2. The two, they are similar. Can you see? So already you have a part of your formula that you're just gonna take and go and substitute when you have to apply the arc length formula. So as we said, once you have found this for x function, now you can start looking now for the y function. And the first step is always to look for the derivative of the y function. So it's gonna be d dy d theta. So already I've explained all the steps, the identification of your function, so you can see. So the derivative of a sine give us what? Give us cos. Here we have a product rule of what? Theta and cos. So we're gonna derive theta first, which give us minus cos. Then derivative of cos will give us what? Negative sine. So we're gonna have a positive there. So it's gonna be theta sine. Okay? And therefore, the two cancel each other. So now you are going to have 5 theta sine theta. Okay? Once you have found this theta theta, that dy d theta, now you can look for the power of it. So it's gonna be d dy d theta squared. So you put all of that under a square. And therefore, now you will observe that when I have 25 theta squared sine theta. Okay? So you can see now we manage to have the two parts of the formula. What are the two parts of the formula? Is these two. Okay? And therefore, once we have to apply the formula, we know that we expect to have d dx d theta squared plus d dy d theta squared, which will give us what? 25 theta squared cos theta squared plus sine, 25 also. So you have 25 theta squared sine theta squared, and then you have a common factor. Common factor is what? Common factor is 25 theta squared of cos 2 theta plus sine 2 theta. So if you look at your identity, this will give us what? This will give us 1. Okay? So after we got our part already of the formula, so our third step is just to apply the formula. And then we know our formula of the arc length of the parametric is going to be theta 2 theta 1, the square root of d dx d theta squared plus d dy d theta squared derivative of theta. Okay, so now you substitute. You have the first is going to be pi over 2 over square, which is our limit in where we are looking for our integration. And therefore, this, all of that, we got it as 25. So it's going to be 25 theta squared dd theta. Okay, and then this, you can see that they are under the power. All of that will give us what? Pi 2. And then here we're going to have 5. The square root of 25 is 5. And then squared dy. So now we're just going to integrate this. The integration of 5 theta is going to be 5 theta 2 over 2. Why? Remember the integration, it's all about 1. If you have a 2 power, we are doing integration of it. It's going to be what? X 1 plus 1 divided by that x plus 1. That's what I applied there. But I still have to determine my limit. Okay? And therefore, if you determine your limit, what you're going to see is going to have a 5 of pi over 2 squared divided by 2 minus, since we have 0, we're going to have everything minus 0. And therefore, the final answer is going to be 5 pi squared over 4. That's how you approach it. Okay? So our last example today, it's going to be in a rectangular coordinate. So we know our formula of rectangular coordinate is given by b a square root of 1 plus d dx d dy. Sorry, it's d dy d dx squared, all of that, that derivative of d dx. Okay, so again, we'll try to break it into pieces, because once you break it in pieces, you don't make any mistake. So the first thing we are going to look is the derivative, d dy d dx. Once you get the derivative, you get the power of it. So it's going to be our second. Okay, and then after we get it, then we look for all of that. Can you see? So it's all about, you break it in pieces, you look for the derivative. After you get your derivative, you apply your square, your power of 2, the square root of 2, and then you move step by step. You won't make any mistake. Okay? So without going any further, as I said, the first thing we are going to look in order to apply our formula, we need to get determine the d dy d dx of our function. So we can come here. You see, you have a 5 cos x over 5. We are looking for the derivative. Okay? Already, our 5, since 5 is a constant, we keep it aside. We don't care about it. So when you have to derive cos, okay, you have to take the function. Okay? Everything that comes after a trigonometric function, it will become a function to it. So it's like a couple. Where I have a function, even if I have x squared plus 1, or if I have cos x, okay, everything after the trigonometric function become a function to the trigonometric. Okay, so therefore we're going to derive that. It's going to give us what? 1 over 5. Okay, and then cos turns to what? It's going to change to sinh x over 5. Okay, and then this cancel that, so your final answer is going to be sinh x plus 5. Okay, and then the second things we need in our formula is the power. Okay, and so it's going to be d dy d dx to the power of 2. So you came this function, you put it under square root of 2, so it's going to be sinh square root of x plus 5. Okay. And then the third things we need in our formula is 1 plus d dy d dx squared, which is going to be 1 plus sinh squared x over 5. Okay? So if you look under the formula sheet that I put in the website, I put an additional formula sheet. So you know that cos squared x under the identity of hyperbolic is going to be given by minus sinh squared x equal to 1.
And therefore, our cos squared x will be equal to what? 1 plus sinh squared x. Okay? So we can see that we are at that case where we have 1 plus sinh of a function. So that this is going to give us what? A cos squared x. And therefore, we say this is the same notation as cos x, x over 5, the power of 2. Okay? The two notations, they are the same. Okay? So once you have get those three parts, then now you can come and apply your formula. What is your formula? Your formula requires you to, for the arc length of a coordinate is gonna be B, A, then you say 1 plus d dy dx squared plus d dx. So now look, we have already everything. We have to substitute just b is equal to 2 and 0, and therefore our 1 plus d dy dx squared is given by cos. Remember? It's given by cos squared d dx. Okay? And then this cancel that. Okay, so now we're gonna have an integration of 2, 0 cos x over 5 d dx. So we just need to do the integration of this formula. Okay, and then the easy way to do it. So now, what happened now? We're gonna derivate this one, but we're gonna put the inverse of it in front. Okay. So now, let's see what's going to be the derivative of the function of this cos. Derivative of this is going to give us what? 1 over 5. Okay? So the inverse of this is going to be what? 5. Okay? So therefore, what's going to happen, we're going to put our derivative here, in front here. As we say, the inverse of the derivative. Okay? So now we're going to have a 5, then cos change to what? Cos change to sinh. Then you have your sinh over 5, and then you have to determine your limit. Okay? So once you have to determine your limit, so now you come here, you say, my first limit is gonna be 5, you keep the constants, sinh of 2 over 5, then minus sinh of 0. So all of that is going to give us an answer of 2.054. okay? So I will try just to do a small revision when it comes to integration of this trigonometric function. Okay, another way to do this integration of this trigonometric function, it's all about you take a u, because I know already that cos of x, let's say cos of x will give me sinh when I do it the integration. But remember, this is a unique function. But when you have such function, what do? Take u, substitute. For instance, u is equal to, my function is going to be equal to x 5. D du is going to be equal to what? 1 over 5 d dx. Okay? And then d dx will be equal to what? 5 ddu. So you change your integration to a function of u. So you have your arc length of 2, 0. Okay? So then you have your cos. This change to u. And that, what is the value of your u? X plus 5, or over 5. And then ddx. Ddx change to what? Change to 5 ddu. Okay? And now you can see that now you have a unique function. And then this unique function will give us what? Sinh u, you keep your constant 5, and then you determine your limit. And now you have to change. What is the value of u? U is going to be given by sinh u it x over 5. That was our u when you apply a u substitute method. Okay, but anyway, I'm just gonna require you to go and have a look on some
I'm just gonna require you to go and have a look on some video under match 2, because I have to give you access to watch that video. So you're just gonna go and watch those video and then download those additional formula sheet I put. Everything will be on the website, but if you have any question, you can always ask that question in the group. Or as well, I'm going to upload a memo to question 1 until question 5, so that you want to have a look on the step, the way I approach, because you cannot do everything here on video. It's gonna take a long video that you cannot watch. Okay, thank you.